All right.
Are you ready? Specialist Kelvin?
Yeah.
Technician Kelvin?
Yeah, man.
We made a few videos this morning on this Whale Mcclain Ultra 3 299, and you know what? I wasn't going to bore you with most of it, but I'll play a little clip right here. Watch this. It's not a sword. It's actually a Whale Mcclain part that's made specifically to chop off Kelvin's head. No, it's made to get inside the sections like that. See? That's what it's made for. Just to do that. So we're gonna do that to all these burners, I mean all these tubes, and get that nice and clean, and we'll be good to go.
See, I could be funny. I could be funny. I'm Mikey Pipes, come on, I'm funny as can be.
Yeah, man.
I'm the funniest guy around. Anyway, we're going to our next service call, and this is gonna be a good one. Customer has a Dunkirk gas-fired boiler that was carbonized, and another contractor, quote unquote, scrubbed it out. But he's still having, it still doesn't work.
So they gave up,
and now the homeowner's calling somebody else, and this should be interesting, folks. This should be interesting. Let's see how they really scrubbed it down, and I want to see if they did a combustion test, which you know they didn't. So stay tuned. I'm definitely going to get some good ones of this, and maybe I could even add the word boom and explode and fire into the title of the video, and I'll get a million views off of it. All right, stay tuned.
What's going on with this thing?
So I had some guys come. They took it apart. They cleaned it out. They scrubbed it because it was carbonizing or whatever. And they vacuumed it out, and it worked. But the flames was rolling out like maybe a couple days after that.
So they didn't scrub it?
They, okay. I saw them scrub it.
They didn't scrub it enough, though.
I saw them scrub it. They scrubbed it out. They had the vacuum. They got in there. They took the vent and all that stuff out.
How long did it take them to do it?
They was here for about 2.5 hours, maybe 3 hours. They was here for a minute. Because the guys before them, the sensor right there.
Yeah, the rollout
sensor. The rollout sensor, they just had it twinned together. They didn't have a
fuse. Oh, so you can burn your house down.
So the previous people came, they changed the gas valve and then twinned that in. And then, so when the other guys came, they saw that they took this whole thing apart, they scrubbed it and cleaned it.
Yeah.
But it's still, the flames are yellow, and then now it don't even come on.
Yeah, it's not going to come on. Wow.
What do you want to do, salvage it or replace it?
If it's salvageable, I'd rather salvage it for now.
We're going to take this whole thing apart and scrub it down. And again, I don't know what the other company charged you, but...
All right. I am on my way to my shop, which is literally like about a mile and a half away. Literally. I have to go get the soot vac. I'm going to get the soot vac, and Kelvin, I left Kelvin behind. He is going to start taking apart, you know, the flue pipe and the covers, the jackets of the boiler. So we'll get some video of scrubbing this boiler down. Stay tuned.
All right. Just got back with the soot vac. Holy shit. What did they do when they cleaned this thing? Wow. Oh my God. What a disaster. Well, we're gonna scrub this down. If I can't dial down the gas valve, change that out. Pilot tubing, thermocoupling, rollout switch. Oh, let's get scrubbing. I already did the first section. Kelvin, come in here. Hold that.
Damn.
All right. So, very easy. Yeah. Some of them, you can go down at an angle.
This Dunkirk, pretty easy. I go straight down between every single little crevice between the sections. Just like that. So Kelvin,
yo,
I'm doing this. I want you to get the other two burners out of there, all right? All right. Put the light back up here. We're gonna bang this out. Take a closer look. Hard to see, but every single nook and cranny is now clean. We got a little bit right there. We'll hit that one up right there. And a little bit right there. Okay. The last one. Look at that. All right, we have to just clean that one right there. Very limited space here, but I need to get these other two burners out of here. Dunkirk, you suck. Just saying. Just saying for a friend. Get that monstrous pile of carbon that we scrubbed out of here. Look at that. Insane. Crazy.
Tune up. I mean, scrubbing, but there's the original tie down when it was shipped. So it doesn't move during shipping. See that? That piece of wire straight ahead? They never even took the burners out when they scrubbed this boiler clean. Oh my God.
Look at that. That's the original wire to hold the cast iron burner when this was shipped.
Damn.
Look at that. They never did a proper cleaning when they scrubbed this down. What a shame. Shame on you, whoever did this. Disgusting. But you know what? We're making the money. Thanks to these idiots. But don't pay twice, pay once. If your contractor doesn't pull out a Testel 320 to do a combustion analysis or a combustion analyzer, throw them the fuck out of your house. Straight up. No other way of saying it. So, for shits and giggles, I had Kelvin just grab me the lighter, because I'm going to replace the pilot tubing anyway, and the pilot assembly, and the thermocoupling. But there's your culprit. This is why the boiler carbonized. If you got a pilot flame the size of the Statue of Liberty torch, then you got big problems, buddy. Wow, look at that. It's crazy. Obviously, the thermocoupling is good, but we're going to change that anyway. You know where the pilot burners are, Kelvin?
Yes, you want
the. I'm replacing the pilot tubing and the thermocoupling to start. I'm going to start by taking off thermocoupling from the gas valve. And on the other side, oh, lefty-loosey, righty-tighty. Come on, get in there. In case any of you are wondering, I've discussed this before. This is 3/8 and 7/16. See that? 7/16 and 3/8. Perfect, perfect for thermocouplings and pilot tubing. All right, I'm gonna redo this. You know I'm getting a bender too, don't you? All right, we'll secure that to the middle burner. This one, and we'll get her done.
Tubing bender.
All that. Last bend on the gas tubing. I want to get a little creative with this one because the gas is coming into the side of the White Rogers gas valve. All right, and we have a height of roughly 1.5 inches rise. So that'll be like that. And let's just put that to a 45. Boom. That goes there, which is dead center there, and this is going to get cut. Let's see, that's going right there. That's getting cut right. Oh, not so perfect. Oh, Mikey Pipes. Not so perfect today, Mikey Pipes.
not so perfect. All right, because I have the gas there. This, put it over here. Gotta do these wires over too. That's gonna go in there like that. That's gonna go up like that. All right, up a little bit right there. Can I clear the gas valve right here? Yes, I can, I think. All right, so I'm gonna cut that right there. Okay.
Oh, Kelvin, you have a Milwaukee mini tubing cutter, huh?
Yeah.
All right, so I'm going to cut this, put one more little bend on it, and then I'm going to hook it up to the gas valve. Stay tuned. All
right, replaced the gas valve. Rebent tubing with my tubing bender. I'm going to make my last cut when I put it together. There you go. Save it. All right, let's secure the pilot tubing.
Watch your head.
Watch my head, why?
Oh. Adjustments. Too bad that was missing a spring. Look at this. It's horrible. Check draft. Alright, Kelvin's gonna test out. Let's see, where's the thing? Let's see. It's just you, buddy, both of us. What are you doing? Still zeroing out. Come on, Kelvin. What are you doing? I swear, so today you're just dumb.
Today.
One mistake after another today, Kelvin.
Yes, sir.
You see the shit that I tolerate?
Stupid, my bad. Everybody just see it, my bad.
Let this run for a little bit and we'll see what kind of numbers we got. Stay tuned. I'm still dialing in, but we're almost under 30 particles per million. Our O2 is within a good range. Stack temperature, again, it's an older boiler, so but still 435 is all right. CO2 is also within range, and right now 81% efficient. So trying to get that down to as close to zero as possible without bringing down the gas pressure too much. But we want to try to get near perfect combustion. And if we have zero particles per million of carbon monoxide, we have perfect combustion. When we first started out, you know, she was hovering around 180, 160 ppm, you know, particles per million. But right now she's at 24. As you see, Kelvin's got the probe where it belongs. This is the diverter for the air, so you don't want to dilute the air. You don't want to drill a hole there. You want to be at on top of the cast iron. So it looks like we're going to be at 23. I'll try to bring it down just a hair a little bit more.
Called Dr. to the rescue now.
Yep. So that's how you do it. Oh, 22.
Mm-hmm.
We're getting there. Alright. We'll let that sit for a little bit, but see our temperature is creeping. See that? 21, 22, 21, 22. It wants to go lower.
We're gonna be around 21, 22. All right.
We're gonna finish cleaning up this mess here. Print the results. Another satisfied client's got heat.